Hey everyone, this is Nick, and I wanted to jump on really quick because I saw a post by Nolan Hames on Twitter of Nolan Hames Creative, and he was showing a new feature in the latest update of the PowerPoint add-in called BrightSlide, which we've done other videos on in the past, but it's such a cool productivity add-in, and I totally recommend that you download it. It's from a company called Bright Carbon. It's a free PowerPoint add-in that you can download. And one of the cool things that the new feature allows is format painting in terms of charts, format painting of charts, which is something that we never really could do before. So you always have to sort of update every single element of every single chart one by one. You can see the chart here on my left is a chart that I have sort of updated and edited. I removed the grid lines, added direct labels, all the good things that we know we're supposed to do to charts. And then the chart over here on the right is a default chart that I just embedded right into the slide in PowerPoint. And this is what Microsoft will give you if you want that 2D clustered column chart. This is just the automatic chart that pops up. But wouldn't there be a great way if I didn't have to go click by click by click and kind of make all these updates manually to a chart? If I just had this template chart right here, in using the BrightSlide Painter, I can easily and quickly copy the formatting in just one click. So let's go ahead. I'm going to highlight this chart that I've already formatted. We're going to go up to the BrightSlide tab here and go ahead and click on the Multi-Painter. The Multi-Painter will paint other things like tables as well. But I'm going to go ahead and click this. That copies all of this chart's formatting onto the clipboard. And when I click this chart, everything should update to this one exactly. So let's see what happens. All right, it gives me this pop-up. It does its magic, and you can see like everything is perfect. Now I'm going to click Multi-Painter again to make sure that I unselect that, but every piece of formatting is the exact same. It removed the grid lines, it put on direct labels, it used my custom colors, it also updated the fonts. Everything is the same. That's so amazing, and it's a different chart type too, right? Because this was a column chart before, and now this is a bar chart. Let's go ahead and see if it will do something a little bit more unique. This is a horizontal lollipop chart, so it's not a default chart type in Excel. You have to do a little bit of hacking on the back end to make this happen, and these lollipops are actually just error bars, part of the clustered bars that were there. So if I kind of click in this white space, you can actually see where the bars live. Those are just set to the color, the fill color to no fill. And then these are all error bars here in each of the columns. But can I do the same technique here with a format painter and have it format over this default column chart? Let's see what happens. I'm going to select the chart, go up to the BrightSlide tab here, click on the Multi-Painter tool. It's on the clipboard because you see that little icon in the paintbrush, and I'm going to click the chart. And it worked. Everything is right there. Perfect. Now, I haven't tried this with some really custom charts like maybe dot plots or things that usually take a lot more sort of hacking behind the scenes, but I can see a lot of uses for this Multi-Painter and this chart format painter in the world of sort of productivity when it comes to designing your slides. Particularly if you have maybe slides like small multiples or charts like that that you need to sort of update really quickly and on the fly. So I hope you go ahead and download that BrightSlide add-in. Just go to brightcarbon.com and you'll find BrightSlide there. And I hope that you enjoyed watching this video. I enjoyed making it for you. Remember, you don't have to be a professional designer to look like one with the software that you already use every single day. Thanks again for watching, and I will see you next time.